This is Mia. Right now, she's online with a friend complaining about their social media platform, MyFace. Is MyFace worse than other social platforms? Not really. But there's a new social platform called FriendSpace that promises not to demand access to contacts and other data. Sounds great, right? Mia makes an account on FriendSpace. Now, she tries to move her photos over. MyFace won't allow it. Oh no! She tries to move her contacts. Nope, not happening. Because she doesn't control her data, MyFace owns them. Mia has built a successful mid-sized manufacturing company called Technova. Her company is at an important stage, and the new product could make a breakthrough at the big annual trade show. The team wants to use an outside 3D vendor. But when the data goes to the printer vendor, Technova's data is out there forever. Competitors could see it, or the vendor could sell it. Technova has no control over its data. The internet exploits them. Maybe a solution to the 3D printing problem will come with a cup of coffee. Glancing at the paper, Mia spies an ad seeking women to donate data for research into women's health issues. Mia would love to do this. But there's always a risk when donating personal health data. It could be used to identify Mia because she doesn't have the option to control how it's going to be used. It's the same problem she's been having all day, with MyFace, 3D printing, and now personal health data. Aisha explains that the control Mia seeks is called data sovereignty, and you can get it inside this place, a data space. Data spaces are where people and businesses have the ability to set the rules that put them back in control of their own data. The rules of data exchange and the ability to certify the identity of your partners in a data space are called soft infrastructure. They make data spaces trustworthy. Data sovereignty makes online social life portable, industries more competitive, and our health and lives better. It means you control your data, your business, and your life. Mia and Aisha want data spaces now, don't you? To learn more about data sovereignty, how it adds value and empowers users for personal, industrial, and public data sharing, check out www.internationaldataspaces.org.